Hi, I'm Fred McNeil, and thank you for watching QACTV 7. We're delighted you're with us. You're watching a show called Conversations with Fred. Each week, we have men and women from our community come in and talk about interesting things you need to know about. We have politicians, you name it, we have them. Today, we're going to talk theater. Broadway's been closed for a year and a half. Springsteen's disappeared from his live performance. So this week, we're very delighted. We have Kendall Chairs with us from Churchill Theater. Kendall, thank you for coming.
Thank you for having me.
Now, Kendall, we're going to start from ground one. All my dear friends on Kent Island. Churchill, I'm not going to Churchill. What is it, Churchill Theater, and why should they not cross the Bay Bridge and come join us up in Churchill?
I love that question, and we get that a lot. We're in Churchill. It's just far enough away to be a little annoying for transportation, but it is absolutely worth your time. First of all, when we think about community theater, there are different opinions that people have when you hear that phrase.
Oh, it's terrible. It's community theater. That's not true.
We've heard it all. Yeah. I'm here to tell you that, yes, we put on fantastic productions.
Yes, you do.
But more importantly than that, where else other than community theater can you see your college professor as an army sergeant or your dentist as a police officer? There's this fantastic essay by the playwright Sarah Rule called 100 on community theater, where she talks about how even though her plays have been in professional theaters across the country and across the globe, nothing has touched her more than sitting in a chair in a community theater watching the genuine, raw performances of everyday people.
And they do a great job.
Absolutely. Our costumes, our lighting equipment, our shows continually impress me. The first show I ever saw at Churchill Theater was in, I want to say 2016. It was Michael Whitehill's production of One Flew Over a Cuckoo's Nest.
Michael from Centerville.
Yes, Michael from Centerville. He is not a stranger, I'm sure, here either.
But Ken Kesey, my favorite author, right?
Yes.
And someone made a play out of that, yes.
Fantastic production. And I was going as a courtesy. I had a friend that was in it, and I was like, oh my gosh, I'm going to go see community theater.
Randall, Patrick Murphy, Nurse Ratched,
Right, and now I'm sitting here as an employee of the theater, but I was not looking forward to it. And I sat down, and that set was innovative and nothing I have ever seen on Broadway. He had this netting that's used for, I think, concrete production, but he had this netting across the stage. So there was this literal fourth wall. We often talk about breaking the fourth wall, talking to the camera, the audience. Yeah. But he had a literal fourth wall that when you needed the emotional comfort of not being so connected, you could lean back. There's a wall. When you were in it with the characters, when Billy's stuttering and you lean in, and it was just, I had never seen anything like that. So we're innovative, we're fresh.
Oh, it's great.
You have a great idea, let's do it.
Kendall, I have to ask you, who played Big Chief in that movie, that play, do you remember?
That would be Pat Fee.
What a great role.
Yes, phenomenal role. And talking about our lighting equipment, there was this lovely effect. So in the play, not the same as in the movie, there are a lot of monologues with Chief, where he's speaking directly to the audience, breaking that fourth wall. And Michael invested in this amazing piece of lighting equipment. I think he had used it for a few shows prior, that there was this lovely like rainbow circling, and it just became really ethereal and lovely. So we had the realism of the rest of the play, and then we had this really special moment created with Chief.
Oh, so, I bet it was great.
Pat Fee, it was phenomenal.
Now let's go back in. So everybody knows Churchill Theater, right downtown Churchill. Go past the new fire station. Mm-hmm. Take the first right. You can't miss the marquee, right?
Right.
Plenty of parking on the road or anywhere near it. Describe for me, if they haven't ever seen the theater, it's delightful inside. Describe, the ambiance of the Churchill Theater.
Well, do you know what we're doing right now?
Are you renovating? I hope you're not renovating. I didn't know. Okay.
So, we have an Art Deco theater.
Okay.
So, we always want to pay homage to our roots. The building's been there for over 90 years. It was a community building. It became a movie theater. And then it became the Churchill Theater as we know it today. But we are, I hesitate to use the word renovate or restore. They have very specific like architectural meanings. But we are refreshing the theater. We were given a very, very generous grant by the Maryland Historic Trust.
Oh, great. Okay.
And so we ripped the wall coverings down. If you remember, we had this lovely Art Deco fabric gone. Brought it down to its bare bones. And then we re-insulated the walls. We are currently designing the new fabric.
I can remember, Kendall, when I first went there 20, 30 years ago, whenever the year, there was no air conditioning.
Oh, we fixed that. We fixed that a while ago.
It used to get hot, but then that's changed.
Yes, I know, absolutely. I know. But so now, right, we insulated the walls. We refinished, I say we, like I was in there. I took pictures. I did not purchase
them.
But they refinished the floors. We are getting a curtain. We've never had a curtain.
Okay.
We've never had a curtain that closes an opening. We're doing that. And we ripped out the seats. So if your rear has ever been poked by one of the springs in our old seats.
They're gone.
Say no more. They're gone.
And but it was nice. But like you say, it was old school, but it was nice.
Yes. So new seats are on their way and they're semi-permanent, which opens up the possibilities for way more types of theater than we've ever done before.
Wow.
We can have dinner theater,
theater
now.
In the round
we can have theater in the, oh, I love theater in the round. But dinner theater, we can have tables
so
and chairs.
You can actually move the seats.
Yes. Oh, we can have any kind of configuration we want.
How about I still refresh? Didn't I just get a glass of wine?
Oh, absolutely.
Yeah,
you've gotten a glass of wine.
That will
it's
still go
still
on.
There. We're trying to rethink how we'll do that. We might have people walking. I don't know. I have this dream of having, you know, wearing the boxes with the snacks
the
and the wine.
Yes,
we'll see. We might bring that.
Bogart said I have a pack
of
cigarettes.
Absolutely.
Yeah,
we'll just kind of lean back and that's what I'm hoping for.
So you're constantly changing.
Yes.
Undergoing change. But the ambiance, just the whole setup, easy parking, price is right. Mm-hmm. The theater is very quaint, right?
Yes.
I mean, it's a small theater, but it's nice.
Okay? Absolutely.
Which is great. Now let me ask you, we'll keep moving along here. What has been going on? I get the New York Times every day, and I've been reading the tragedy of the actors, losing jobs, losing benefits, producers, directors looking for jobs. Churchill, how are you surviving?
I am pleased to announce we never touched our emergency funds.
Oh, great.
Like,
okay.
We didn't just tread water. We made it through in a way that I'm so grateful because I know a lot of organizations and businesses, they simply
did
tragic.
Not. It's tragic.
But we spent the pandemic, we produced 5 radio productions via Zoom.
Okay.
2 of which were world premieres.
Oh,
which
wow.
is, I mean, an incredible thing to be able to
now
say.
Now, how
at
can
any
people
time.
Still get, find those somewhere or no?
No, there's certain ways with streaming rights what we can and cannot do. But we had War of the Worlds, in which John Haas, who is a professor at Chesapeake College, he rewrote it with an Eastern Shore twist.
Oh, right.
We did A Christmas Carol. We had...
And people could just pay and get get right on Zoom. Okay.
Yeah, it was so... It was innovative.
How did that go? Did it go well?
Well.
The audience? Oh, it did go well.
We made money off of everyone. No,
very
but
good.
It was so
well,
lovely.
We want you to make money. We want That's good. Isn't that... I always, people are embarrassed about making money. No, you're in the business to make money.
If you would like to donate, please go to churchill.org.
We'll go to that. We're going to give you a couple of high promises. Now, I did go to your website. There's a book club?
Tell me about that. There's going to be a book reading. So that is the first time in my knowledge that we've done something like this.
And now, explain to the audience, because I was impressed when I saw it. Yeah.
Yeah, so we've never done anything like this. Again, I think. Correct me if I'm wrong.
Right.
It's going to be this Saturday and this Sunday, Saturday at 7 p.m., Sunday at 2 p.m.
Okay.
If you go on eventbrite.com, you can search Churchill Theater or Book Talk or Janet Friedman, and you'll be able to order tickets.
Now say that again. Where do they go online again? Remind
eventbrite.com.
Okay, now do they pay?
Yes.
There's a
and it's all right through there, so you use your credit card to pay.
It just tells you where to go.
Yes, and it'll prompt you to make an account. So that when it's 30 minutes prior to the showing, whether you're going 7 p.m. on Saturday or 2 p.m. on Sunday, you will click a blue button. It's very user-friendly, and it'll take you right into a virtual waiting room.
Okay. So you've been innovative. You've done mm-hmm. productions with the Zoom, with themes. Now you're going to do book readings. You got any other secrets we can tell the people about yet, or you're still thinking about it? Oh, go ahead.
Secrets is probably a good way to put it, so I'm going to be very careful with how I answer that question, but we have so much happening, which is a lovely thing for anyone in the arts to be able to say right now, because it's been months and months
of
saying...
Oh, it's been tough, hasn't it?
Absolutely. Tough, not just because it's what we do, but emotionally... Really hard to not do.
You can only watch so many TV movies. You can only watch so many ABBA concerts from who knows when.
Right.
It'll be nice. I can't wait till I get to go to the Churchill Theater, get to go back to New York City again on Broadway, and Washington College, whatever it is. There's something. Well, let's change the topic. We're going to go back. I'm going to keep that you're doing your advertising. I promise you. What do you think? You've taught theater. Mm-hmm. You've been in the theater. Mm-hmm. Now you're part of management theater. What is it that attracts guys like me, and I'm a guy, who normally, you know, okay, I watch a football game, but when someone says, do you want to go to the live stage, and there's some electro, yes, I want to go, and it makes you go to the arts section in the New York Times, what do you think, what is it?
When you're sitting at home mm-hmm. watching a movie,
right.
or when you're sitting at home, or maybe standing angrily at a football game, there's a screen in between you and the players,
right.
or you and the actors. When you're in the theater, you're breathing the air.
Yes.
You're breathing the same air. If you're in a Broadway theater, whatever famous star on stage that you went there to go see,
right.
you are breathing that same air.
And they might have passed you walking to the theater
Absolutely.
2 hours
and
earlier.
And they had like a wig on, you didn't know.
Yeah.
But you're in, to quote the musical Hamilton, you're in the room where it happens.
Right.
And more so than that, as human beings, we are first and foremost storytellers.
Well, from the days we were in the caves, right?
Right.
Looking at shadows,
but
right?
even just talking to you, we are telling stories
yes,
to
we
each
are.
Other.
That's what the show's about.
Right. Yes,
yeah.
absolutely.
Yeah.
And so we want those stories. We crave those stories and then the connection that comes from them. And yes, you can connect to somebody on a screen. I hope you're connecting with me right now. But you can connect to somebody in a room so much more. And that's why you hear the phrase, the magic of theater. And that's again why I have come to love, I told you I was a skeptic, but I have come to love community theater so much more than any type of theater, because we get those stories, we get that air, we get that connection.
Something special.
And you see some of the people you already love and know in a way you would never see them in their own lives. It's unlike anything else.
It amazes me, again, as someone just sits in the audience, the talent. Mm-hmm. In a place, obviously in a place like New York City on Broadway, that people you've never heard of, you will never see on TV, but all of a sudden they start singing mm-hmm. or acting, they grab your heart, they grab your ears, they grab your mind. It's unbelievable. And like you said, locally, it's amazing. The guy, a woman drilling your teeth, it turns out he has a great
voice.
The woman who's helping you at the DMV, she likes to be Nurse Ratched, or whatever it might be. And it just puts life in us. So you think it's that connection of the live performance and the live audience. You can't, my man's cave at home doesn't have that connection, right?
Right?
Which is great. Now, let me go back. I interrupted you before. Innovation, you're talking about innovation. You're talking about, you can Zoom, we've got book clubs. If they're out there saying, okay, they've been dark for so long, what's next? What do you think's next in terms of live stage? Do we have dates? Are we going to open?
Yes.
Oh, yes. Go ahead.
Yes. Hallelujah. So, October 9th.
Oh, that's a real hard date.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Okay. I've got it for you. October 9th, we are reopening our doors with, like I said,
4 months away. Does that sound right? September. June, July, August, September, October. Yeah, about four months or less.
We'll go with four. It sounds right.
Okay.
but with, you know, new floors, new curtains, new everything.
So the theater's going to be great. Okay.
Yes. It already was great.
Okay. Now you're going to keep the quaint box office.
Yes.
When you walk out. To me, that's the... Look.
I love it, right?
I know. You have some person, just as I'm sure they're volunteers, sitting behind the glass, exchanging tickets. That's like out of the 1950s when I was a kid.
And there's something so nostalgic about it, even if you didn't have that experience firsthand. But we're going to have a gala opening.
Okay.
We are finalizing the details, but...
Will that be open for the public?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes, yes, yes. Please, please, please buy a ticket.
Now, let's stop it. We're going to keep on. I'm not going to change. You and I are going to throw out a million ideas over the next 30 minutes. If they're sitting at home and says, all right, Fred, be quiet. Is there a website? All this stuff you're telling me, can they get that off of a website?
Yes.
Well, tell them.
The gala and then what I'll say next are not yet live on our website.
Okay, so because you're not sure of the dates yet.
October 9th, I am sure.
But
if you go on our Facebook page, which is just Churchill Theater, you can find a lot of updated information.
Okay.
But if you do go to our website, which is churchilltheater.org, we do have information regarding our book talk event that's happening
this
weekend.
I saw that right away. Okay, so they can do that for this weekend or any time in the future.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, which will be good. So go back. You're going to have a gala opening, which will be open to the public.
Come on, let us give some secrets.
All right,
so this is what I'm hearing. They're finalizing details, so I can't guarantee, but I'm hearing black tie. I am
at the theater.
At the theater, yeah. I just ordered my dress, so they better keep that one.
Okay.
I'm hearing black tie. I am hearing hors d'oeuvres, cold and hot.
Okay.
Live music.
Oh, wow.
Scenes from past productions we've done. We will reveal our 2022 season, so we'll be doing that in person, which we've never done before.
Like a sneak preview, a trailer, what's going on.
So it's this grand reopening of the theater, welcoming people back to what they know, but also showing off where we're going.
Okay. They'll see the new look of the theater, which no one has seen before.
Right. I mean, we still haven't even seen it yet because it's in the middle of the
renovation. It's still in the middle
of it. I used the word renovation. I said I wouldn't do that. Okay. But refreshing.
It changes. Changes. Okay.
And then going back to our roots.
Go ahead.
For 3 weeks in November, I want to say the first three weekends because of how Thanksgiving lies, we are going to have a musical.
Oh, wow. So that's all. That's working. Can you tell us what it is or not?
I cannot.
No doubt.
Well, but I can
Sheila Grasso is watching. Remember, she knows my
phone
number.
You're right. She'll get on me. But I can say that a little birdie seems to really enjoy this title.
Oh,
so
wow.
We will be obtaining the rights hopefully next week once it goes through board approval. And so we've got a gala and we've got a musical. And then I've got one more for you.
No, keep going. Keep going.
In December, we are going to do a live radio production of A Christmas Carol. So rather than going through Zoom, because I don't know about
everyone
else.
Do one of the station, a local station?
Well, we're thinking about maybe tying that in, absolutely, but we know that we will have them in our theater. People will see them as they're performing the radio play, and we want to establish a holiday tradition at our theater. It's been several years since we've done that. I think I'm done now.
No, well, I think, now, my children, I think years ago, they're in the 40s, used to have activities for kids in the summer. Is that in the, you still do that? Or?
Yes. So we have our Green Room Gang summer production every summer. It's 5 weeks long. It's a camp that culminates into a junior performance and a senior performance.
Are we able to do that or not?
We are doing a version of that
COVID
this summer.
COVID still is there, right?
Right. Okay. And now we probably could have done it, but we didn't know that when we were in our planning phase.
Okay.
So starting Monday, actually, we have a two-week. We are rebranding it for this summer as Young Actors Workshop. So they will be meeting every day, Monday through Friday, for 2 weeks. And then they'll have a little filmed performance at the end. But next summer, Green Room Gang will be back.
Okay, is it too late now to get into this year's? If someone's watching this and saying, hey, I'd like my kid to go to that. Too late for this year or not?
No.
Oh.
No. And again, I probably should say yes, but I'm going to say no.
Just
email.
Call, email. By the way, what is a number you like to use when if someone wants to call?
Well,
I'm always lucky. I always get you.
Right.
Fred,
I
want to
hesitate right now because our business hours are off, but you can always reach us via email, which is office@churchilltheater.org, or my email, which is businessmanager@churchilltheater.org.
Now, people now also, all of a sudden we're saying, hey, it's a black tie event. I can get hot and cold hors d'oeuvres. This will happen in October. And then November, they're going to kick off some activities. And Christmas time, they're going to, winter holidays, they'll have some activities. If people were sitting out there and say, let's go down the whole list. I'd like to act. Mm-hmm. I'd like to collect tickets. Mm-hmm. I'd like to volunteer or serve the wine if they'd like. Or, you know what? I'd like to send a check to Kendall. Tell me what, let's go one at a time. If you think you're a dentist and you're tired of drilling the teeth, and I'd like to get interested in acting, what do we do?
Well, I'm going to lump a couple of those together.
Throw them together.
So if you want to act, direct, do lighting, you have to have zero experience, I'm here to say. Just reach out to us right now, since we're not in auditions, that won't really happen till maybe August or September. Reach out to us via email. Just say you want to volunteer. Now, you mentioned, which I love that you mentioned, if I want to sell refreshments.
Sure.
That is a fantastic way. If you want to be a part of a community organization, but you have absolutely no interest.
Don't want to get in the stage.
Yeah, you don't want to be like sitting in the hot seat. You can see the show for free. If you can't afford a ticket or you don't want, volunteer to sell refreshments. You get to sit in the back, you help us out, and then you can sit, watch the performance, again, sell refreshments. If you want to be involved in any way, it doesn't have to be theater related.
Sure.
Give me an email, give me a call once we're back in normal hours, and I'd be happy to set you up with that.
So actors, directors, producers, yes, you could use help. Hey, if you want to serve the wine, how about ticket sales and stuff like that? Need help in that area? Is that
absolutely?
Oh, okay.
Absolutely.
Anything. How about cleaning up? I mean, the theater empties. There's an awful lot of candy bars.
Yes.
I mean, need help and stuff like
Please.
That.
Please, anything, anything you could think of. If you have fantastic video editing skills, we've been trying to make more content to put online in this interim period, and right now I'm editing it. I don't think it's horrible, but it's certainly not my best skill.
You'd rather get a volunteer and know what you're doing.
Absolutely. Okay. So, any skill you think you have, even if you don't know if it's related to theater or not, I'm here to tell you I'm sure it is.
Okay.
I'm sure we could use you.
And if they call you, you can probably find a place to use them. Is that correct?
I can definitely
because it's community
find
theater.
Them.
And how about the $64,000 question? If they want to write you a check for $64,000 or $6 or $4, mm-hmm. can they do that at any time?
At any time. Okay. You can always send it. Our post office is right in Churchill. It's P.O. Box 91. I'll take any and all money.
Okay.
In fact, we are trying to look for funds right now to, I will use the word restore and renovate here, our marquee. If you've driven past our theater.
That's the beautiful marquee as
yes.
I see that you had
yes.
intermission on for the last year or for a while. Anyway,
yes, yeah. I love that phrasing
that
for
was
this
good.
Period,
that was done
intermission.
Well.
But yeah, so we need to renovate and restore our marquee.
Okay.
So we are currently looking for funds for that. So if you have okay. some money you would love to donate back to the community, I would love for it to go to that project.
And you
project.
Can't, look at if you're going through Churchill, you're not gonna miss
it.
That marquee.
Mm-hmm.
You're gonna see what the next play is or whatever it is you wanna have up there. So you guys have made it so far, fingers crossed. It looks like you and Broadway are gonna make it through the COVID mess.
Absolutely.
And now we're seeing some plans of October we have an event, and then after that, yada, yada, yada. Mm-hmm. And the kids can start going to activities again. So it's the wheels are beginning to turn, and the theater hasn't been renovated. It's been updated. How about
yes.
that? Will we go with that?
Yes, that sounds good to me.
And volunteers are needed.
Always.
Okay.
In any capacity.
Now, how about, let's talk about my friend Sheila Grasso for a second. Sheila, I apologize, but we both like you.
This is my fault.
This is a wonderful theater teacher who did a great job mm-hmm. at the Queen Anne's County High School. Is she producing and directing again or no?
She never stopped.
Good, that's what I like.
And she will actually be spearheading the committee that is doing the gala. So her pet project.
So it'll be a great event. It'll be a great event.
Anyone that knows Sheila knows that it will be perfection as close as that is
okay.
possible to make happen.
Okay, so she's active. Now, about her husband, is he still doing sets?
Yes, he actually was in our theater doing the floors that we were restoring. So he was buffing them and finishing
him.
Them. Yeah,
Carmen's they're not going to slow down. They're not going to slow down. No. And a question I've always asked, did you buy the building to the right of the theater that used to be a hardware store? Is that part of theater now?
No, it's not. So that's still owned by someone else. But man, that would be a lovely space for us to obtain.
Well, help me out. It used to be now when my wife and I, Elaine, who you mm-hmm. taught with, across the street, there was a restaurant that used to serve food. That's gone, right?
Mm-hmm.
That's a shame. Okay, but folks, don't worry. All my friends at Kent Island who don't go to Churchill, why would I go to Churchill? Plenty of places to eat in Centerville or the drive up from Kent Island, okay, to Churchill. Don't even worry about it. Or you can go to Upper Queen Anne's County, delightful places, which is good. I'd like the kids camp. I didn't know you still did that. That's terrific.
Every summer. It's part of our mission statement to have opportunities for all. So we will never stop providing educational opportunities for students.
Now, they say once you're on the stage or the classroom, you never leave the stage. Do you participate in the plays at all or no? You're out of that business.
Well, I love theater.
Okay.
I love education.
Right.
And I've been in several productions at Churchill Theater. I've choreographed a few. I will never stop doing theater, but right now when we're trying to bring everything back on board, I need to just focus my efforts on the business
side of things. You're doing theater administration, which is just as important. Someone has to make sure the place is clean, mm-hmm. air conditioned, the food's there in time, and that type of thing.
Absolutely.
Now, we'll take our crystal ball out here. Where do you see the Churchill Theater in 5, 10, 20 years from now? Do you think that far ahead?
I do.
Oh, good.
To a fault.
That's all right.
I envision us really broadening and diversifying our offerings.
Okay.
Now, anything that I say, it's my current
dream.
This
is crystal ball. We're playing the great Swahili here, having some fun. Okay.
So we, as I said earlier, we at one point were a movie theater.
Right.
And I see
right.
us showing companion pieces to some of the plays that we're doing. I see us diversifying.
So we
our
could
offerings.
See the play Phantom of the Opera, maybe the movie The Phantom of the Opera.
Sure.
Is that what you mean? Okay, why not?
Or,
why not?
You know, if we do a sequel play, maybe we watch a film adaptation of the prequel play.
Okay.
Or have a holiday film. That's something that I see. I see us also.
So film plus live theater mm-hmm. in combination, tie them together somehow.
Yes.
That'd be great.
I see a lot more collaboration in our future as
you
well.
You know, Kendall, Lane and I have lived here 42, 3 years. There's no movie theater in Queen
right.
Anne's County.
Right.
Now think about that.
Mm-hmm.
no movie theater. What a service you'd be offering if you could do something like that, right? Hey, guys and gals, we're going to have the live stage, but you know what? We're going to put some Orson Welles stuff, or we're going to put, I mean, I don't know what you'd put on.
I don't know either. We're not there yet, but yeah, I would love to fill that
need. Oh, that would be great, yes.
And that's the thing is, I don't want to just put on programming to put on programming. We really want to fill a need.
Sure.
But in addition to that, I see a lot more collaboration in our future. I've been speaking to a lot of leaders and other organizations in our area, and there's this energy that I think because we're coming off of the pandemic, I know we're still in it a bit.
People are tired of being inside watching TV.
We are ready to work together to better our community, particularly when it comes to children, when it comes to education. Yes. We really want to broaden what we offer them and find that safe haven. I was just filming with a couple of our Green Room Gang members the other day, and one of them said that this is a sanctuary. He used that word, sanctuary. Oh, yeah. And I choked up when I was listening to the clip because I'm like, it's so
Well, it's
so
like walking in a
true.
Church when you walk in that theater.
Absolutely.
It takes you to a time and a place that it's not there anymore.
Right.
I mean, I love HBO and I love all my TV programs, but you know what? A theater, there's something different. Matter of fact, we talk all the time, will theaters, movies recover from the pandemic? Are people now going to be so trained that, you know what, I'll just turn on TV, I'm not going to get in the car? And what a tragedy that would be if they don't get out, have that glass of wine, and mix with people.
You know, I can't speak to film because in the grand scheme of the world, it's a relatively new media.
Sure.
But theater has survived so many things
throughout
history.
Thousands of years.
It's been outlawed. Oh. It's been looked down upon. It's gone through so much hardship.
Yes.
And it has survived and thrived through all of it. So I have no fear about theater going anywhere. Film? I don't know. But theater, it's here to stay.
Something like South Pacific. I mean, the first time you see South Pacific, oh, isn't that a quaint little love story in the Pacific Islands? And then the next time you go about, this is about race. This is about concerns, contemporary concerns. And Bali High, you know, we're talking about mixed marriages. We're talking about all types of things that, you know what? It was going on in the 1940s, and it's certainly going on in 2021.
Well, it's interesting that you specifically bring up South Pacific, because Sylvia Maloney, who is another huge name for Churchill Theater and a retired teacher from Kent County, she was talking about when she directed South Pacific a few years ago at Churchill Theater, and she was like, the reality of South Pacific. And my initial reaction was like, what? What do you mean the reality of South Pacific? Because I was looking at it through the lens you first described.
Yes. And quaint then love story during World War II. Yeah.
Right. And then when I stopped to really think about what she was saying, I was like, oh my gosh.
Yes.
There is a universal truth in what they endure in that musical, and there's a universal truth in any play that we can connect back to ourselves or people we know. I think Sylvia used the phrase a mirror to life.
Oh, the whole thing about teaching you to hate.
Mm-hmm.
Who teaches you to hate? Where does it come from?
You see it.
And when you fall in love, hate kind of falls out of the place. Well, good. I think the Churchill Theater is alive and well, and that's great.
Absolutely.
Now, I'm going to have some fun. I have about 2 minutes left. Are you ready for the toughest questions of the day?
Okay.
All right. Favorite ice cream?
Vanilla, but only because it's the only one I can make from scratch.
Okay. All right. Favorite actor, male, female categories? Stage, theater, whatever you like.
I don't have
Take
one.
Take it down. Oh, okay. Good. You're better than I am. Okay. last good book you've read? Take your time.
I'm currently reading The Handmaid's Tale. I've been influenced by the Hulu show, and it's phenomenal. But the last great book I read prior to that would probably be Bird by Bird by Anne Lamott.
Okay, now what's that about? Go ahead.
It's nonfiction. It is meditations on writing and life.
Oh, wow.
And as an artist, it just really appealed to me.
Okay. Favorite place you've ever traveled to? Churchill doesn't count.
Darn.
Sorry, Sheila. Didn't count.
Wow, favorite place I've traveled to. I don't have a wide history of traveling, but I would say traveling to New York City.
Okay.
Even though that's not always the best theater, but having the opportunity to say I've seen
it's Broadway.
Right.
Come on.
But honestly, going to Philly, D.C., those professional theater productions, those
Kennedy Center or anything is just as good, right?
Sure. Yes.
Okay, which is good. If you could have dinner with any male or female, you can go back as far as history as you want, who would it be with?
My husband.
All right.
Did I win?
You won too, but he's home grinning and says, Matter of fact, he's home quickly dusting, doing all these good things right
yeah,
now.
Yeah, picking up the shoes in the corner that I trip on every time.
Well, Kendall, first of all, thank you and thank Churchill Theater for what you're doing. You're doing great. Mm-hmm. And let's go take a minute here. If you want to volunteer, give money, sweep, do yada, 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 they should go to your Facebook place. Right?
Yes.
Churchill Theater.
Yep, you can either go to our Facebook, which is Churchill Theater, or you can go to our website, churchilltheater.org.
Okay. And if they want to email you with a question, mm-hmm. what would you like them to do?
Businessmanager@churchilltheater.org.
Okay. Let's not call yet because your hours are a little strained.
Yeah, I just don't want to mislead people.
And let's remind everybody again, the October 6th, am I correct with that?
9th.
October 9th mm-hmm. will be your reopening, so mm-hmm. go to the website and go to Facebook and keep an eye on mm-hmm. that. You have coming up in the near future a book reading activity.
Yep.
Some things going on for the kids, mm-hmm. okay? And then, like you said, as we get in November and December, the wheels are going to start turning again, all right? Please make sure you know everybody, even the Grasso family, is welcome to come on the show anytime and brag about what you're doing, okay? And we'd love to share it with the audience,
perfect.
Okay?
We will definitely be back.
And thank you for being with us. I really appreciate
thank
it.
Thank you for having me.
I'm Fred McNeil. Thank you for watching QACTV7. Please, if you have the chance, go to the website, go visit Churchill Theater. I think you're going to leave there with a smile on your face and you're going to be pleasantly surprised how great it is, local theater. Again, thank you. My time's up. Thank you for your time. We're going to see you next time.